What I'm gonna do first is I'm gonna take this program panel where we see our video that's here in the timeline, and I'm gonna drag it on top of the source panel because I kind of want to see our color up close so that we have a good view of what we're doing. Now, this color, I feel like it's looking a little flat and dull, so I want to jazz this up. And so we're going to grab another panel up here for our color. You could go to the color workspace if you want, but I'm just going to go here, and then we're going to go to this panel right here. It's called Lumetri Color. This is what you want, Lumetri Color. All right. Here's our color panel over here. I want to talk a little bit about how this panel works first at a high level. So you're going to see different sections here, and you can click and expand these sections, and each one is going to have settings for, you know, each one of these sections. These sections kind of start, you should kind of start by doing some basic corrections, and then you're going to get creative and add some styles, you know, and then you can get down here and there's some really fancy tools that let you get super, super sophisticated with a color if you want and pinpointed. And they get more complex. They're a little bit more of a learning curve. You could just live your best life up here in these first two sections and get a lot done though. Okay. Ain't no shame in that. And you can always learn the other stuff later. All right. So for now, we're going to, you know, whatever clip that you've got selected in your timeline, let's expand this basic correction section first. You're going to see as I'm adjusting the settings, they're going to apply to that clip only. Okay. So I'm just going to maybe make, oh, I do want to point out though, there is a nice, beautiful little auto button down here. Okay. If you just want to do something real fast, you can click that. And a lot of times it'll do a great job. Sometimes, you know, like any auto button, you might need to tweak it a little bit. So like, I feel like the exposure is a little high. I'm looking a little ghosty. And if you don't like what it does, you can click the reset button. All right. So in my case, I am just going to adjust things just a little bit. Maybe I will just, you know, boost these highlights a little bit, and then I'll lower these shadows a little bit and give a little bit of contrast. Cool. I could check over here. You'll see there's a checkbox here that I can check, and I can see the before and the after. All right, so we did some subtle little correction there. Cool. We're not done yet because we're going to add a creative filter. So go down here and click on this second section here called creative. This is kind of like where you're going to find Instagram filters for your images, and you can preview those filters here. So you can click the arrows to preview a look. This, in Premiere, they're called looks, creative looks. Those are your filters. So this is showing you what the look is going to look like if it's at 100% max, but we can adjust the intensity. And so what I'm going to do is I have found one that I kind of like here called S Big LDR. If you want to do exactly what I'm doing, you can find that one, S Big LDR. And then to apply this effect, this look to our clip, we're just going to double click it and bam, there it is. All right. And now I'm just going to lower the intensity a little bit because I'm thinking that was kind of intense. And you know what, Premiere, maybe you were right. You know, maybe I did need to be a little better exposed here. Okay. So I'm thinking that that is looking really cute. I'm popping right now. Right. What I want to do now is obviously I want to add these settings that we've done here. I want to apply this to the rest of my timeline. That's really easy to do. So what we're going to do is we're going to select this clip that we've done the settings for. We're going to go up then into the Lumetri color panel. We're going to go to the top right hamburger menu, and then we're going to go to save preset. This is like it's, you know, already prepped and gotten all of our settings preset, and it's going to create an effect for us with these exact color settings. Then we're going to get a dialog box to say, what do you want to name this preset? And let's just call this gear org color. Press enter. All right, cool. We've got a preset. Where is it now? We're going to find that preset over in the effects panel. It's just a bunch of effects that we've added. So now we're just going to search for gear or color. Here's our preset that we made. Bam. And now we're going to select all of the clips on our timeline. Then we're going to hold down the shift key and just deselect that one clip where I've already done the color too, because I don't want to double it up and look too popping in that one clip. And now we're just going to drag this preset onto our other clips, and bam, everything has been corrected and everything is popping.